Hello friends, welcome to this next video of Geology Education Series. Today we will be learning about how to prepare for field work. Our today's guest is Dr. D.B. Guha. Dr. D.B. Guha did his MSc from Banaras Hindu University in 1979 and did his PhD from Punjab University in 1985. From 1984 to 2017, he worked for the Geological Survey of India and retired as the Deputy Director General. During his illustrious career, Dr. Guha had been involved in mapping in the Doda area in Jammu and Kashmir, mapping of Aravali, Delhi and Himalayan fold belts, mapping of granulite and metamorphic terrains, and had been involved all over the country in gold exploration, base metal exploration and rare earth element exploration. Today, Dr. Guha would be teaching us about how to prepare for field work. Such a basic subject coming from such an experienced person would give the students a great opportunity to learn, and I hope the students take advantage of it. If you like the video, please subscribe it and circulate it. Thank you so much and welcome Dr. Guha.
Hello, I am Dr. D.B. Guha, Deputy Director General of the Geological Survey of India. And today I am going to give you a lecture on basic concepts of geological mapping in the field. So these basic field concepts, which are to be considered before undertaking such a mapping project, that what are the things we should have before proceeding to the field. So one of them is the field notebook. A field notebook should be of a moderate size, say 7 to 8 inches long and 4 to 5 inches wide, which can be held by hand easily and must be hard bound. Hard bound is necessary because otherwise it may just worn out in the field in due course of time. So this field notebook should contain ruled pages and unruled pages, blank pages also, so that hand sketches can be drawn over the within the field notebook while carrying out the mapping work. And this field notebook should also contain some graph pages, either at the end or in between some pages, so that some sections or spot sections over some mountainous spur or river section, etc., can be drawn along in the graph paper on a scale-wise manner. So these are the things which should be taken into consideration for selecting a field notebook. Having a good quality of paper which does not soil in rainwater or like that, so this will be better. So some of the field notebooks I am showing you, which are used normally by Geological Survey, these are the hardbound field notebooks. Left side is the notebook with the leather bound, and right side is the canvas type of paper. It is bound over here. So this is the type of field notebook. The length you can see, and the width you can see, and the thickness of the field notebook is about, say, 50 pages to 80 pages. Like that, and you can have one more than one field notebook with you, so that if one is finished, the next is utilized. So now comes to the apparel, to the dress you wear for field work of a continuous field work in an area, either in a mountainous terrain or in a terrain tropical climate where you have thorny bushes and these sort of things, and you have to climb certain boundaries made by local people and jump from over it. So your field dress should be very comfortable, and the trousers should be loose enough so that if you bend your leg to the maximum, the trouser doesn't create any problem. So, and it should have even several pockets on both sides of the leg, and it should be made of hard cloth, something like denim cloth. And the shirt should also be of quite loose and comfortable, and with full arm length. Why full arm length? Because this will save you from scorching sun heat in a tropical climate, or even from the cold climate also. And in a thorny area, your hand will not be tethered with these thorns. So this should be a full arm length. Your shirt should be like that. And it should be worn in a way that a field jacket should also be taken over the shirt. And this field jacket should contain several big outer pockets with flaps, so that field equipments which you are taking, like pocket knife, pencil, rubber, pen, etc., can be kept into those things very easily. Your shoes must be tough enough as per the area you are going to initiate. the type of area you are going to map in a hilly terrain. You may have a mountainous or hilly terrain or the rugged areas. The shoe must be of trekking type. For example, in India, you have woodlands trekking shoes which you can take, and they have very hard sole. So you will be safe from thorny bushes and other types of pointed rock types also. So this saves the mapper from thorns penetrating his foot. For desert and fluvial or coastal or flat sedimentary areas, the mapper can simply use some tennis shoes for comfortably doing the mapping. So these tennis shoes are obviously comfortable than the trekking suit, because trekking shoes are quite weighty, and they sometimes you get tired of those shoes. So in flat terrains or in fluvial areas or coastal areas, you can do this mapping with the tennis type of shoes. The other field gears which are required while going for mapping are, first of all, the important most is the topographic sheet of the area where you are going to map in its original form, and also a Xerox copy of it with you. So that in the field, you may take the Xerox copy for mapping along, and you keep your original sheet in your satchel, and you go on putting your location and other details into the Xerox copy, so that even if it's wears and tears, the original sheet is with you, and the locations and other details noted in the Xerox copy will be transferred to the original sheet in later time when you come back to the camp. Then you have the most important thing is the Brunton compass or a regular compass. So Brunton compass is more better because this will give you direction in a proper way, and some surveying work can also be done with this Brunton compass. So this is required for taking dip and strike and all those measurements through the of the rock type you are going to map. Then you should have, nowadays we have the GPS. So GPS should be of higher navigation system, at least 8 channel system, or more than 8, it goes up to 24 navigation system. So more than 8 navigation system GPS should be with you. Then we have used this diagonal scale in the field for directly taking the dip and strike data in the map without the help of any other instruments for drawing the dip and strike on the map. And also a normal 12-inch scale should also be taken for measuring certain things which you require during mapping. Then you should have some good geological hammers, like S-string geological hammer with pointed and chisel end. And then you should have big hammers of at least 5 pounds or more for working in hard terrains like granitic rocks or granites of very hard nature, where these small hammers of geological simple hammers will not work much. You cannot break big samples. Then other field gears are, which are important, is a pen knife. This pen knife is normally used for understanding the relative hardness of the rock or the mineral you are trying to identify. And this, by scratching with the pen knife, you can make out, because you know the hardness of the iron, and in relative to that, whether it scratches the mineral or it does not scratch, accordingly a rough estimate of the rock or the mineral or the rock can be made out. You need a HB pencil for drawing diagrams, then an eraser and a cutter for the pencil for drawing diagrams and doing more this sort of work, or writing down the details in the field notebook. You should have hand lens and measuring tape also. Hand lens is very important for identifying the mineralogy of the rock type you are taking out at certain locations for study and for making thin sections, etc. So that you can make out the general mineralogical composition of the rock and give a name in the field itself. So this hand lens is very important for knowing the mineralogy of the rock type. A measuring tape is required for small distances to measure, or while doing some compass and traverse method of mapping in the smaller areas, for specifically for noting some lithological or stratigraphical detailing in the field if it is found in say few meters by few meters area. So you can map that area, and you can use this measuring tape and the Brunton compass to do the mapping on a very large scale. And similarly for structural detailing also, this sort of large scale or very large scale mapping is done on say 1:50, 1:100, this sort of scale it is done. And you must have polythene cotton bags and polythene bags and canvas bags for rock samples and ore samples. For ore samples, canvas bags are more required because these are normally sharp and heavy, and normal cotton bags may wear out. So canvas bags for this, and for normal rock samples, you will require a polythene bag. Then you should have a satchel, which should be hanging either with your shoulder, or a rucksack, which are normally used in the hilly terrains like Himalayas, etc. Rucksack is very important in hilly terrains, where your bag is on the back, and as a lot of space is there to collect samples and other things. So this is required in Himalayan type of terrain. And otherwise, a normal satchel or a backpack is all right for normal mapping in terrains like in the cratonic areas or in the small fold belts in these cratonic areas. You require a very important thing, which is a streak plate. In the field, if you get certain mineral, you have doubts, or some ore mineral specifically, so you can use that streak plate, see the color of the mineral by making a strike on the streak plate, and seeing the color, you can make out whether, say, for example, if you are working in an iron ore area, whether it is magnetite or hematite, the color will be like magnetite. If it is magnetite, it will be black. Hematite, it will be brown, like that. So every mineral has got its own streak. So this streak plate must be taken into the field. There are phone apps applications available for field geology. Nowadays, these applications are free of download, which may be installed in the mobile phone. And with this phone application, some oriented photos can be taken with this inclination during photography in the field. And continuous photographs may be taken in the field to show any geological section of a larger extent. And these may be joined together to make a film or condensed photograph showing the geological features of the section. So this is how you go for geological mapping, and these are the basic concepts which should be taken into consideration while going for any geological mapping of any type in any area for a specific purpose. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for such a comprehensive description of how to be prepared for a field working, and what are the things to be considered and in the geological mapping part.
In the next part of this video, we'll be looking at some of the specific Android applications. They are probably available for other operating systems as well, that many geologists use, and those that have proven a lifesaver for our life in the field. Please subscribe and please circulate. Thank you so much. See you in the next part.
Thank you for watching the video. I invite you all to please visit the Mineral Exploration Academy website and register yourself. The registration is free, and registration is open to students, teachers, professionals, or anybody who is interested in mineral exploration. The registration will also provide you an access to be able to ask questions from our experts, and also provide an opportunity for established experts to answer and interact with the students. The registration form is available on the Mineral Exploration Academy website. I would also encourage you to look at the editorials and opinion sections, and visit the student question and answer section at the bottom here. In the student question and answer section, the questions asked by the students are being answered by our experts. Our experts are the top people in the field, and it would be a wonderful learning opportunity for the students, for probably the questions that occurred to you but you could not ask, or to review questions what have occurred to other people and get the answers the different experts are providing. Thank you so much, and I look forward to interacting with you a lot more.